exercise 2.3, question number 1, fourth subdivision. We are given 96 is congruent to x by 7 mod 5. Now this x by 7 is to be an integer. Because this is congruent relation, this x by 7 must be an integer. So what are the possible values of x? The possible values of x are 7, 14, 28 and so on. That is multiples of 7. Now by trial and error method, let us try x equal to 7. When you put x equal to 7, 7 by 7 is 1. 96 minus 1, 95, which is divisible by 5. So the relation is satisfied. So when you put x equal to 7, this congruence relation is true. The possible values of x are 7, 14, 28 and so on. Let us test each value. Put x equal to 7. 7 by 7 is 1. 96 minus 1. That is 95, a multiple of 5, true. Therefore, x equal to 7 satisfies this congruence relation. It is the least value. So, x equal to 7 is the least positive value. That is the required value of x. A little. The problem can also be done in a detailed fashion. Given 96 is congruent to x by 7 mod 5. To avoid the fraction, multiply both sides by 7. 96 into 7, 672 is congruent to x mod 5. That means 672 minus x is equal to 5n, where n is an integer. That implies x equal to 672 minus 5n. Now this x must be positive. Therefore this 5n must be less than 672. That is n must be less than 134 and 2 by 5. So n must be equal to 134. Or n equal to 133 and so on. Let us check up. If n equal to 134, x equal to 2, x equal to 2 is not possible since x by 7 is not an integer. If we take n equal to 134, then we get x equal to 2, but x equal to 2 renders is x by 7 as a fraction. When you put x equal to 2, x by 7 is a fraction. So x equal to 2 is inadmissible. Let us take the next value, 133. Lower value we must take because n must be less than 134, 2 by 5. We have already taken n equal to 134. That is not possible. Therefore, we take the next lower value, 133. When we try n equal to 133, x equal to 672 minus 5 into 133 in this equation. So we get x equal to 7. X equal to 7 satisfies that equation because x by 7 is 7 by 7 is 1. So x equal to 7 is the least value that satisfies the given congruence relation. The problem is done.